He was about 24 or something. And he had a little band, he had an electric guitar. And I said, hey, let me play your electric guitar. It was so nice. And he made a record in Austin in 1950. And it was Austin Jukebox. He said, years ago, I recorded this for Rolling Rock. And it became a song that some of my rockabilly people that I meet now still know. So I'm going to do it for you now. It's called Quit Your Trifling. I went home, stuck, and I had to sit. Oh, my baby, thank you again. I think I could have tried for love. Thank you. words ain't nothing but new on her Thank you. second here. We have a surprise for you.
How old? How old?
And you're 60.
Yeah.
You know, I remember way back in the last millennium, somebody played me a tape of this guy, Ray Campy, from the old Austin City Limits TV show. And I said, wow, rockabilly. I knew what that was. Most people didn't. I still don't. But it was pretty damn good. So I learned a bunch of songs. I got a chance to play with him at a party. And from then on, I was a rockabilly rebel. A couple months later, he says, how'd you like to go to England? And I says, are you kidding? You know. So I went to England. First of many fun trips over there. That was a real eye-opener. And that was, how long ago? 37 years ago. 37 years ago. Now, you know the great thing about playing together for 37 years? The band can appreciate this. You never have to rehearse. So we got a surprise for Ray. See, I grabbed his mic. They don't call it rambling away from me.
A diaper!
This is your life, Ray Campy. So we've had a lot of guys come through this organization over the years, and we got somebody here tonight, a surprise for Ray. Used to rock with us a long time ago, and I don't think he brought his axe, but he's going to come up and rock with us again and help us do this Carl Perkins song, Gone, Gone, Gone.
This is Jerry.
John, drum roll if you please. All right, from right here in beautiful downtown Burbank, Bill Scorin. Come on up. He's a close of about 30 years, I think, experience with this team.
Hey, Bill, hey, good to see you,
bro.
Good to see you.
Right dead.
Not yet.
All right, man, let's try. Let's go ahead and see.
Yeah,
I'm just going to
help us.
Okay. Let me look around. Go. Hey. That must be my door. Your soul look like
thank you.
about 3 months older or a little. I'll be 80 in October. Ray's older than I am. I'll be 80 in October, and Ray is 80 now, so he's older than I am. Okay, let's do one more of my songs, and then I'll get out of here. Here's another one of my songs that was in a movie. It was called Road Racers. Remember Road Racers?
Yeah.
It was called One Cup of Coffee and a Cigarette. It was like this.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Johnny May. We're going to take a very short break, and we're going to bring up the guest of honor, Mr. Ray Clampy, in just a few minutes.
Thank you.
Martin's 30th birthday. Linda Ronstadt gave him this guitar. That night he went in and wrote A Bad Case of Loving You.
Yeah.
Became a number one record for Robert Palmer on this guitar. He decided to move to Nashville, where he calls his old buddy Rocky Burnett to say, can you help drive all my equipment back to Nashville? I said, well, you know I do play in a rock and roll band. And he says, you don't need the money though, do you? I go, no, I don't need the money, but the people I owe it to would sure love to have it. So we loaded up all of his equipment here in Los Angeles, right here in the San Fernando Valley. And we went south to Nashville, where he bought himself a log cabin with a little studio garage. And while making his way back and unloading his equipment, I found his baby, knee-deep in the mud from a flood that had just gone through his place. And it had been busted in half by a forklift. And I said, Moon, what are you going to do with your hummingbird? He loved your hummingbird so much. He goes, I know. Some guy with a forklift smashed into it, and he'll never be the same again. So I said, could I have it? He goes, yeah, Rocky. Go ahead and take it. So I asked the world over, can you fix my guitar? And everybody said, no, that guitar will never fly again. Until a buddy of mine named Steve said, I know a guy up in the Angeles Forest. He's like a guru. And he fixes guitars like yours. So I took it up there. That was 2 weeks ago. And he's put the guitar back together. The guitar that would never fly again is once again playing its first gig. Like a restored 32 Roadster. Like a restored 57 Chevy. And here we go now to Intrigue Caparoli. And it goes like this. I get along, a single little woman get along. I get along, a single little woman get along. Oh, when the heat and the fall, I just get along.
Thank you.
the moon. I know you couldn't hear me. Is that a key?
Yeah.
your birthday. How about one more, Ray? One of your classics. She's fat cat.
Thank you.
We got lots more music coming up.